what does it feel? Because you wrote many songs, you've done several recordings, and this song is maybe your
claim to fame.
I heard he sang a good song. I heard he had a style, and so I came to see him to listen for a while.
You know, in the very beginning, I felt a little bit maybe embarrassed by it somehow. I felt like it was hard for me to say this song was written about Don McLean. I felt like that's kind of corny. And then Roberta Flack had the big hit. After hearing my version, I felt a little, you know, kind of happy about it. But then there was this feeling of
jealousy, maybe
a little bit, a little jealous, a little, you know. And then there was this in the States at that time. There was this sort of a fight between, I like Roberta's version better, I like Lori's version better. It was this big silly thing. Pictures in the paper of Roberta, me, and then Dawn, you know, she stole my song. It wasn't that at all. She made it something I wouldn't have, you know, ever have done. I never would have done this kind of a two-feel that she did. You know, she was really very brilliant. And I never would have added the, whoa, you know, ever. And she, you know, was very creative with it. Mine was a very simple, you know, folk song.
And he just kept on singing clear and strong, strumming my bed with his fingers, singing my life.
That's when music for me was changing from, you know, James Taylor, Carole King, what I did, to disco. It was really a hard time for me. I couldn't relate to the business at all. I didn't know where to turn. My kind of music really wasn't the kind that people were playing and that, you know, people were enjoying at all. In fact, it was a little embarrassing to be a long-haired singer-songwriter with a guitar.
Softly with his song.
I finally had the last straw when I went into this office, and I was, you know, I had a meeting and I had some desperation, I imagine, about my career myself. I walk in, the guy's on the phone, you know, and he sees me walk in, and I've never met him before, and he's like, hey, and he just keeps talking, you know, I don't know, you want to try this restaurant for dinner? Maybe we should. And he was on the phone for like 5 minutes. I'm looking at my watch and I'm just thinking, okay, I'm going to give him about like 30 more seconds, and he's still on the phone. And I just walked out, got in my car, drove off, and I said, I am done. I'm so done with this, and I never looked back.
Strumming my pain with his fingers, singing my life with his words, killing me softly with his song, killing me softly with his song, telling my whole life. With his words killing me softly.
As the years went by, I kind of disclaimed it as though it wasn't a part of me. And then, as I said, Lauryn Hill recorded it, and my kids thought I was cool. And now I recorded it again on this record because I'm not proud of it. I now go, you know, I heard he sang a good song. It was like, that's me, you know, and that's, I'm very proud of it, actually.
Strumming my pain with his fingers, singing my life with his words, killing me softly with this song, killing me softly.
When was the transition completed for you? Lauryn Hill, or maybe years after this?
Yeah, a few years after Lauryn Hill, when I realized that I could then again talk about the song with a new perspective. I sing the song now with compassion for who I was back then.
La la la.
was it 40? Oh my
God. I think it is.
God, 72? Is that 40 years?
Almost.
I swear, I never thought I'd live past 10 years old. I can't believe it's already that. It's crazy.
Oh, but you're 70, yeah.
Yeah, God. I do. I remember exactly feeling that way. But more than that, now I feel, you know, it's, you'll see when you get to be my age, it's almost like you'd want to say to your younger self, it's not so serious. Courage wasn't the huge things that we do. It's not the gigantic acts of courage, but it's the small things. It's getting on a bike to come here. It's sitting at a table. It's having an interview. It's walking through a storm. It's giving up, giving in, and grieving, and all these things that take courage. It's the small acts of courage that we display as human beings every day. And that how brave we all are every single day. How brave.
No, but I think then for you, I think it was brave for you to return maybe into the music scene.
Yeah, you're right. I think it was brave.